COVID-19 pandemic. Big Bird that is spreading human suffering, infecting the global economy, and upending people's lives. We are in an unprecedented situation, and the normal rules no longer apply. We cannot resort to the usual tools in such unusual times. But that doesn't stop the Digbianos to be resilient in these times of trial. Ladies and gentlemen, to honor and celebrate the feast of our patron saint, Immaculate Conception, welcome to the very first virtual Debit Night with this year's theme, The Cultural Revival.
If my people will humble themselves, and pray. If they seek my face and humble themselves and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven and forgive their sins.
Municipal officials headed by our municipal mayor, Mayor Elizabeth Mandin Pase, municipal councilors, our EDCOM chair, Councilor Virgiluna Lurot, the parish priest of Immaculate Conception, Reverend Father Mark Caballo, DepEd family headed by our school's division superintendent, Dr. Benito Dagatan, parents, learners, stakeholders of the Department of Education, to all Katigbianons, good evening. Welcome to the first ever virtual DepEd night. The teachers and school heads and the whole DepEd Katigbian district, despite this pandemic, the teachers of Katigbian district elementary level will showcase our talents as gesture of thanksgiving to our patroness, the Immaculate Conception. In behalf of DepEd Katigbian, I welcome you all to our show. Please hang on and enjoy the show. Viva Immaculada Concepcion!
were tripping off me before I even knew her name. La la la, you felt like ooh la la la, yeah, no. Sapphire and moonlight, we danced for hours in the same tequila sunrise. Her body fit right in my hands, la la la.
I wish it wasn't. originated from the Maranao people who inhabit the shores of Lake Lanao. It is a retelling of an episode from the Maranao epic Legend Darangin, involving the rescue of Princess Gandingan, abducted by Diwata by the legendary Prince Bantugan. It is a popular dance performed during celebrations and other festive entertainment. The dance takes its name from the heavy rings worn on the ankles of the Muslim princess. In an episode of the Maranao epic, the princess is caught in the middle of the forest during an earthquake caused by the Diwatas of the Kingdom of Bumbaran. The Diwatas abducted the princess and entrapped her into a forest to teach the philandering prince Bantugan a lesson. The falling trees during the earthquake are represented by the bamboo poles arranged in a unique syncopated rhythm. During the performance, the female lead dancer graciously steps in and out of the bamboo poles. Another female dancer represents the loyal slave of the princess who accompanies her throughout the order. The entrance of the male dancers symbolizes the arrival of Prince Bantugan, who is determined to rescue the princess from the Diwatas. The dance steps require agile movement so that the dancer's feet won't be crossed by the moving bamboos.
Thank you. My dear peace-loving and God-centered mentors of the Department of Education, as years keep on rolling, Katigbian District, under the able leadership of our school district supervisor, we are again celebrating the Feast of Immaculate Conception. This department is a strong partner of the local government unit in molding our children to be good citizens of our society. On this occasion, we honor the Virgin Mary, our intercessor and protector in times of difficulties and tribulations. She is our guide as we continue to teach our children during this time of pandemic for reaching the authentic Christian community. Let us make this celebration more meaningful and blessed for thanking God and sending us a defender and His steadfast love and providential guidance as molder of the youth. Throughout the years, God is always with us to help and convey our knowledge to our children in order to transform them to become more aware of the needs of others and the community as a whole. May this celebration be an opportune time to deepen our relationship with God through the Blessed Virgin Mary. Let us remain preserving in faith, untiring hope, and Christian love. A blessed and happy fiesta to all.
Akong itunol ang kinasing-kasing pagtimbaya o pagtahod sa atong mga kadaguan sa Department of Education din sa lungsod sa Katigbian, headed by Mrs. Gemma Anisita N. Ladroma at our school district supervisor. Sa tanan ng mga DepEd family, both elementary and secondary level, sa itong mga magtutudlo, sa atong mga parokyano, tanan Katigbianon, sulod o gawa sa atong nasod, sa atong mga devoto o devota, sa atong mahal na patrona, o sa atong mga Facebook viewers. Diha kaninyong tanan, mayong gabi, mayong palis, mayong udto, mayong hapon, o mayong adlaw. Sa makausap pa, magahibon na usap kita sa pagsaulog sa atong mahal na kapistahan, pahinungod sa atong mahal na patrona, ang Birhen sa Immaculada Concepcion, atol sa ika-172 nga kapistahan karong tuiga. Medyo adunay kalahian sa atong pagsaulog nining maong pangilin. Ngano man doon na may kalahian? Una sa tanan, niya kita sa panahon sa pandemya. Ang maong sakit ay kahadlukan sa tanan. O maunay nga nahingawa sa kita nining maong sakit. Maong tailikay kita nining maong katalagman o pandemya sa tibuok kalibutan nga nasinati. Ikaduha, diha sa itong pagsaulog, adunay pagdahimuon nga umaabot nga lockdown karong December 7 ug 8 sa itong pangilin mismo. Busa ako nagawag sa itong mga parokyano na bisan pa man o maghimutag maginagmay mga hikay, pagpasidungog o pagsaulog sa pangilin, ayaw po mo kalimot paghatag sa inyong panahon, pagsimba, pagpasalamat, pagdaig sa itong mahal na patrona sa maong adlaw. Bisa pa, magtapok-tapok ta, inigulit na to sa itong tagtag sa kapanimalay. Din kita mangaon, pagsalo-salo sa pangilin. Nakita-kita ra. Ikatulo, nga diha sa itong kasaulugan, atong gihimo kining maong mga kalingawan o presentasyon pinagi sa virtual presentation or video presentation aron kita malikay sa maong sakit. So ato din ang ipasibya diha sa Facebook account sa atong parokya. So sa mga muhimo sa ilang pasundayag, ang DepEd family, tugoti ko sa pagpasalamat. Paghatag sa akong kinasing-kasing na pasalamat diha kaninyo sa inyong mainiton nga pagsuporta, pagkooperar, paghatag sa inyong panahon aron kita makahatag og kalingawan sa mga katawhan nga naa sa inyong tagtag sa kapanimalay, no? Nga kamo malingaw og malipay usab sa atong gipakita og pasundayag. So ayaw mong kalimot, no? Kamo mga katawhan nga nakikita nini, sulod o gawas sa nasod, ayaw mong kalimot pag like, share, and thumbs up sa atong mga kalingawan nga gihimo na to atol sa atong siyam ka mga adlaw nga nobedaryo. So sa ngalan sa atong parokya sa Immaculada Concepcion o ako nga inyong kura paroko, tuguti ko sa pagtunol sa ahong mga panghinaot nga unta sa atong pagsaulog sa Pangilin, kita magmalampuson, magmalinawon o magmalipayon kitang katawhan nga nagasaulog sa Pangilin sa atong mahal nga patrona, ang Birhen sa Immaculada Concepcion. So kaninyong tanan ako panghinaot nga kita naa sa kanunay ligon ang atong pagtuo o padasi kita sa atong kaugalingon taliwala sa mga pagsulay ng atong nagian. Viva Birhen sa Immaculada Concepcion. Daghang salamat kaninyong tanan.
Honorable Mayor Elizabeth Mandin Pasip, Sangguniang Bayan Committee on Education Chairperson Councilor Virgiluna Loroth, Immaculate Conception Parish Priest Reverend Father Mark Caballo, all local government unit officials, Katigbian District Supervisor Dr. Jima Naldosa Ladroma, school principals, teachers, non-teaching personnel, retired teachers, key to 12 learners, parents, Katigbian parishioners, and all Katigbianons worldwide, a pleasant virtual evening. It is indeed an honor and privilege to receive an invitation from Dr. Ladroma to give a brief message as you are going to have the virtual Deep at Night, an opening salvo of the first novenario in honor of Immaculate Conception. Your celebration tonight with the theme, Praises and Thanksgiving, Honoring the Patroness Immaculate Conception, is a solid proof that despite this pandemic, the Department of Education, the local government units, and the Immaculate Conception Parish is one in showing to the world that without divine intervention, we are nothing in this world. Showcasing teachers' talents through cultural presentations is your way of praising and giving thanks to the patroness and, of course, to our Almighty Father. May our faith be more strengthened with the pandemic we are facing. For our dear teachers, my warmest and sincerest appreciation for your efforts and continued support to the activities in your communities. This only shows your dedication and sincerity to fulfill your obligations. We shall all be reminded of the two important laws that guides us when it comes to community participation. It is the Code of Ethics of Professional Teachers and the Magna Carta for Public School Teachers, which states, among others, that every teacher shall live for and with the community, and shall therefore study and understand local customs and traditions in order to have sympathetic attitude, therefore refrain from disparaging the community. And every teacher is an intellectual leader in the community, especially in the barangays, and shall welcome the opportunity to provide such leadership when needed, and to actively be involved in matters affecting the welfare of the people. For our parents and learners, let our faith in God be our guiding stars as we continue our journey in this world. As our Education Secretary Leonor Briones puts it, education must continue in whatever forms because it is our mandate to provide basic education to all Filipino learners. With that, we should say, Indepet Bohol, we care for all, Dihol Bohol. Happy Fiesta and God bless everyone.
pag sandugota ato ning sa ulugon pinaagi sa puradang sa puradang kini mao ang sayaw gikan sa atong kapigulangan ug sa paghinumdum ta sa panaghigala diligaspi ug sigatuna atong ipasigarbo ang mga mitip sa atong katawhan. Halamanong halamanang manayaw ta puradang puradang kini ang pagambahan sa gawin sa atong katawhan. Dali magsinduho ka akong sa ulubong pinaagi sa puradang inday manayaw ta ukuradang ukuradang kini ang pagambahan sa gawi sa atong katawhan. Si kapuna
sigarbo ang mga ngiti sa tungkat tawa.
Just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. Hey, hey, hey. Kahit a blessed evening to each and everyone, especially to our parish priests, Reverend Father Marcus A. Caballo, our local chief executive, Elizabeth Mandin Pase, local government officials who are here with us this evening virtually, and to all our viewers from all over the world. It is truly a blessed evening as we are all here celebrating the opening of the 2020 Feast of the Immaculate Conception despite this trying time. I would like to thank all our viewers for giving and sharing their time to celebrate with us. Let us all recognize the efforts of the members of DepEd Katigbian for making this event a successful one, especially to the lead persons, Ma'am Gemma Anisita M. Nadroma, or PSDS, Ma'am Juvie Ayenza, and Ma'am Leonora M. Lastimosa. This year, we honor the glorious and miraculous Immaculate Conception of our Blessed Mother, an act of God's most profound mercy in a totally different way. We forgo the traditional large gatherings to limit the spread of coronavirus. We seek for lower risk options to celebrate the feast, and we may have mixed emotions to what we call now the new normal. But we should move forward and always be grateful to all the graces of God. All we need is hope and strength, hope that it will eventually get better and strength to hold on till it does. And while we are waiting, whatever hardship, challenges, indecisions, and fears that we are facing, we just remember that these too shall pass, and by the grace of God, we will overcome. This pandemic may have brought us anxieties, fears, and uncertainties, but we are capable, strong, and resilient. We may not be able to control the situation, but we can control ourselves, our thoughts, actions, and choices. We can rise above these challenging times and continue our mission as disciples of Christ together as one Katigbianan community. And as we end this activity tonight, let us honor our Blessed Mother through our prayers and act of kindness to every mankind. Let us seek her motherly care this day and throughout the years to come. Thank you for watching, everyone. Viva Immaculada Concepcion!